Good morning all. Today I, Dr. Neha Ronald William, will going to teach you about acute respiratory infection. Definition: a severe infection that prevents normal respiratory function is an acute respiratory infection. It typically starts in the nose, trachea or lungs as a viral infection. It can spread to the entire respiratory system if the infection is not treated. Acute respiratory infection prevents oxygen from being absorbed by the body, which led to death. People suffering from this disorder urgently need medical assistance. Acute respiratory infections are often contagious, meaning that they can spread from one person to another. The disorder is somewhat common. It is especially dangerous for infants, older adults, and individuals with deficiencies of the immune system. Acute respiratory infection kills an estimated 2.6 million children annually worldwide, according to the World Health Organization. Acute respiratory infection with a wide variety of combination of symptoms and signs can cause inflammation of the respiratory tract anywhere from the tube to the alveoli, depending on the site of infection. Acute respiratory syndrome can also categorized by clinical symptoms syndrome and are referred to as acute upper respiratory infection and acute lower respiratory infection. Acute upper respiratory infection of the upper respiratory tract include a common cold, pharyngitis, and ear inflammation. Acute lower respiratory infection, epiglottis, inflammation of the epiglottis, the flap at the base of the tongue that prevents food from getting into the trachea, windpipe, laryngitis, bronchitis, pneumonia, is lower respiratory tract infection. Upper respiratory tract infection, it is commonly considered the upper respiratory tract is the airway behind the vocal cord. Typical upper respiratory tract diseases include tonsillitis, pharyngitis, some form of influenza and the common cold. This affects the nose, sinus, pharynx, and larynx. Lower respiratory tract infection, the trachea, bronchial tube, the bronchioles, and the lungs composed of the lower respiratory tract. Generally, lower respiratory tract infections are more serious than upper respiratory infection. Of all infectious disease, lower respiratory infection are the primary cause of death. Bronchitis and pneumonia are the two most common lower respiratory tract infection. Influenza affect both the upper and lower respiratory tract, but more harmful strain. More harmful strain tend to bind to receptor deep in the lung, such as the particularly pernicious H5N1. Epidemiology, agent, microbes, bacteria, viruses, host, genetic susceptibility, immunization, environment, sanitation, social context, healthcare, availability, agent factors. The microbial agent that cause acute respiratory infection are various and include bacteria and viruses. They often exhibit within species a wide variety of antigenic types. Disease occurrence is determined by whether a secondary bacterial infection occurs or not. Host factor, children of preschool and school age, nutritional status of children, immunization status. Environmental factor, crowding, poverty, poor access to healthcare and immunization. Malnutrition, daycare, environmental, tobacco, smoke exposure, air pollution, indoor air pollution, aspirated foreign bodies, pieces of toys, nuts, pieces of food, cut corners of plastic mesh bag, incubation period 5 to 7 days, modes of transmission, airborne route transmission. Airborne transmission is the spread of infectious agent as aerosol that usually enter the respiratory tract. Unlike the infectious droplet, these tiny particles have the ability to remain suspended in the air for a long period of time and travel long distance. Airborne transmission occurs by particles that are suspended in air. There are two types of particles, that is dust and droplet nuclei. Contact transmission, direct contact transmission, it transfers to person of microorganisms through actual physical contact. Indirect transmission occurs when a susceptible person comes in contact with a contaminated object. Symptoms of ARI, that is acute respiratory infection. The symptoms of acute respiratory infection and lower respiratory are different. Symptoms of upper respiratory infection, cough, fever, running nose, nasal congestion, vomiting, body pain. Symptoms of upper respiratory infection typically last from 3 to 14 days and alternative diagnosis such as sinusitis, asthma, pneumonia, bronchitis may be considered symptoms last longer than 14 days. Lower respiratory infection. Although often used as a synonym for pneumonia, other form of infection, including lung abscess, acute bronchitis may also be affected. Symptoms include shortness of breath, fatigue, tiredness, and fever. There are several signs that are typical of infection in the lower रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक, ब्रोंकाइटिस, एडिमा आर द टू मोस्ट कॉमन डिजीजेस ऑफ द लोअर रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक. प्रिवेंशन एंड कंट्रोल ऑफ रेस्पिरेटरी इन्फेक्शन, अवॉइडिंग रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक्ट इरिटेशन बाय इंडोर एयर पॉल्यूटेंट पॉल्यूशन सच एज स्मोक फ्रॉम कुकिंग फायर. अवॉइड द यूज ऑफ ड्राइड काउ डंग एज इंडोर फायर फ्यूल. फीडिंग चिल्ड्रन विद एम्पल क्वान्टिटीज ऑफ डाइवर्स एम्पल क्वान्टिटी ऑफ डाइवर्स न्यूट्रिशियस फूड टू सस्टेन अ पावरफुल इम्यून सिस्टम. इम्यूनाइजेशन ऑफ ऑल children with an extended regular immunization program. The best way to monitor acute respiratory infection is to improve primary medical care facilities and establish improved strategies for the early detection, treatment and prevention of acute respiratory infection. Educating mothers about pneumonia and the result of the disease is decided by compliance with medication and finding appropriate care when the child suffers. The incidence of mortality due to pneumonia is decreased if adequately treated. Control the spread of respiratory bacteria by forming parents to avoid contact with their children and patients who have acute respiratory infection to the greatest degree possible. By reducing the reservoir of infection in the population and increasing the degree of herd immunity, immunization also improves control. People with acute respiratory infection should cough or sneeze away from others, keep a cloth in their nose and mouth while coughing or sneezing to catch the airborne droplet. Thank you.